For this tutorial you will need your selected yarn, some darning needles, your crochet hook, your scissors and some buttons. In this tutorial I will be showing you how to make this super chunky knit stitch cowl or scarf. This is I describe it as a looser knit stitch purely because I'm doing trebles, so it means obviously the gaps between the rows are bigger, but I just really like how this looks. Just to show you the difference, I will also be doing a separate tutorial for the knit stitch, but this one is done doing half treble crochets, and you can see it's a much tighter stitch, and obviously that means there's more rows in between your buttons and things, but I will be doing a separate tutorial for this one. So the knit stitch is really nice and it is very simple once you start. It is simply treble crochets or double crochets if you're in the US, but it does give lovely ridges in your work that's created by working your trebles into different parts of the stitches from the previous rows. So for this project I'm going to be using the Stylecraft Special XL. It is a super chunky yarn and we're going to be using a 10mm crochet hook. So to start with, you want to create your slip knot. So yarn over and then hold the tail between your two fingers like this, and then yarn over the finger once more and hold again, and you're going to pull this back section of yarn over the top of your finger and then just let go and pull your finger up to create your loop. And then you're going to insert your hook and just pull the long end to tighten up. So we're going to start by chaining the length that we need for our scarf. Now I'm going to do a chain of 56. I found that this is just a generic length that seems to fit most adults so far. Obviously if you're doing one for a child it will be slightly smaller, or if you're doing one for a man again it may need to be slightly larger. But if you go ahead and do your chain of 56, or just your desired length. So to chain, it's just yarn over and pull through. 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 So that's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now that you know how to chain, if you want to work the length of your scarf, as I say, I'm going to be doing a chain of 56. So if you meet me back here when you've completed your chain. Okay, so I've chained my length of 56 and I've just tested it around my neck to make sure that it's not too tight or not too loose, and I'm happy with that. So now I just need to add 3 more onto this chain. This is going to be used for working back along our foundation chain. So 1, 2, 3. And now we're going to start working back with our treble crochets, or double crochets if you're in the US. And we're going to work into the 4th chain from the hook. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're going to be working into this stitch here. And normally when we work back along our chain, we work into the tops of the stitches just here, but for this particular stitch we're going to be working into the bottom part of the chain here. So for a treble we're going to yarn over and then we're going to insert our hook into the bottom of the chain, and you can see you've got the 2 loops there creating the V. You need to make sure that you've got the 2 loops on the top, and then yarn over and pull through. And then we've got our 3 loops on the hook here, and then yarn over, pull through 2, and yarn over, pull through 2. So that's our first one. And then we're going to do exactly the same into the next stitch. So you need to find the bottom loop and you're going to treble again. So yarn over, insert into the bottom, making sure you've got your 2 loops on the top of your hook here, and then yarn over and pull through, yarn over, pull through 2, and yarn over, pull through two. And we're simply going to work that stitch all the way into every single chain, and it's just exactly the same all the way down. So I'll show you once more. So yarn over, insert into the bottom of the next chain, so the bottom of the chain here, making sure you've got your V on the top of your hook, and then you go into yarn over, and then yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. So you're just going to carry that on all the way along your chain. And if you want to, meet me back when you get to your last stitch and we'll do the next part of the pattern. Okay, so I've come to the end of my chain now. I've just got one chain space left over here. So I'm going to do my last treble, or remember double if you're in the US, my last treble into the bottom of this stitch. This one can sometimes be a little bit more fiddly. I'm going to treble into the bottom of this stitch. And then yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. So I've worked my chain now all the way along, doing my trebles into the bottom of my chain. So now we're going to start the next row, and we're going to chain three. So one, two, and three, and then we're going to turn our work. So on this next row, we are actually going to work our first buttonhole, so I'll do that with you. So I've chained my three and we're going to work across. But on this row, normally you would work your next row into the tops of the chains here like this. But for the knit stitch, because we want to start pushing the stitches out at the back, like on this one here, we want to start creating these ridges here. And to do that, we have to push the stitches back. So to do that, we work into the sides of our stitches. So you've got your V along the top here. But then if you look at it from the side, you've got these shapes. You've got these here, like this. And we're going to be working into the side stitches just here. So not along the top, we're going into the side one here and here and here. So I'll do the first few with you, but we are going to work our buttonhole in a moment as well. So yarn over, and then we're going to go into the side of this stitch. So this loop just here, I'll show you that once more. Side here, just like that. And then yarn over and pull up, and yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. And I'm actually going to work my first buttonhole now. So to work your buttonhole, you simply want to miss a stitch. So you're going to chain one and miss this next stitch here and work into the next one just here. So I'm going to yarn over and insert into the side loop, yarn over, pull through, then yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. And you'll see that has created our buttonhole. Now it depends on the buttons that you're using as to what size you will need your hole to be. I'm going to be using these 34mm coconut buttons. So just grab your button quickly and just make sure that it fits nicely through the buttonhole. If you need it to be any bigger, for example, I know lots of people might like to use bigger buttons than this, and if you were doing that, you would simply chain two and miss two stitches and then carry on. So I know my button fits through there nicely. So I'm now going to carry on working along this chain in exactly the same way as we did a moment ago. So we're going to go into every single stitch, I'm going to yarn over, and we're working into the side of the stitches here. So not the top, we're going into the side of the stitch. So yarn over and insert, yarn over and pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. And the next one, so yarn over and insert to the side loop at the bottom here, and yarn over and pull up your loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. I'll do another one with you. Yarn over, insert into the side loop at the bottom, and then yarn over and pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. And I'm just going to turn over quickly just so that you can see how it's starting to push out the stitches along the back here. So we're creating our very first ridge along this edge here. So if you want to continue doing this into every stitch all the way along this row, so into the side, and work your treble or your double in the US, and if you just meet me back when you get near the end of your row. Okay, so I've just gone into the side of that last obvious chain here, and then we've got this chain three here from where we turned at the beginning of the previous round. So we just need to work one more treble crochet into the top of this chain three here. So it's going to yarn over and just insert and try and make sure that you catch the V at the top, just makes it a little bit more secure, and then yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. And then that's the end of your row. And so now we're going to move on to the next row, and we're just going to chain three, two, three, and turn. So you can see that that ridge is quite obvious now from the previous row. And so for this row, we're just going to work all the way along. We're not going to be putting in any buttonholes into this row. We're just going to do one treble crochet into each of the stitches. But this time, instead of working into the side and instead of working into the top V, we're actually only going to be working into the back of the V at the top of your row. So you're going to yarn over and then insert straight into the back loop of the V, and then do your treble. And again, so you've got your V's along the top, you're going to yarn over and insert into the back loop of the V, and yarn over, pull up, and yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. And the next one, yarn over, insert into the back loop of the V, and do your treble. And again, into the back of the V. I'll show you once more, in the back of that V at the top. So if you just want to carry that on, working into the back V of your stitches, when you get to your buttonhole, it is exactly the same. You've still got your V along the top, even where you've got your buttonhole. So, but into the back of that V and into the back of that V where your buttonhole is. And then once more there. And when you get to this one, I will meet you back there. So just pause the video and work along the back loops of your V all the way along. Okay, I'm just coming to the end of my row now. I've just done my last treble into the back of this V stitch here, and we still just have this chain three from the previous round that we need to work into. So you just want to yarn over and insert into that stitch. Again, it can be a little bit tricky sometimes. There we go. And then you just want to yarn over and pull through and then do your treble. So that's it, and there's our buttonhole just here. And so now we want to start the next row. So again, you want to chain three, and turn your work again. And now in this row we are going to be working our next buttonhole, so I'll do that with you. Now we're actually on to our two row repeat now. So we did our first row of normal trebles into the bottom of our stitches, so we can ignore that one. But then we did this row here where we started to push the stitches out at the back, and we're going to be doing that again now. So we're going to be working into the sides of the stitches along here to push out onto the back. So we're going to do our first one. So yarn over and insert into the side of that stitch, and yarn over and do your treble. And then we're going to create our button space. So again, you want to chain one, or however many you need to chain to fit your button through easily. So I'm going to chain one, and then I'm going to miss the side of this next stitch here, and I'm going to work straight into the side of this stitch over here. So yarn over, insert, and pull up, and then do your treble. And again, into the next stitch, into the side, and do your treble. And the next one, to the side. And you're just going to work that once more all the way along into the sides of every stitch. So if you meet me back when you get to the other end, and we'll carry on. Okay, so I'm just reaching the end of my row now. I've just worked into the side of that last stitch here, and now we just have this chain three again from the previous round. So like before, you're going to just yarn over and do your treble into the top of this chain three here. And now we're going to chain three again to start our next row, and you're going to turn your work. So if I just lie this down here now, you can see this is obviously going to be the front of your work, and you can see the nice ridges that we've been creating by pushing these stitches backwards. And now we're going to work all the way along the row again. And this time, just like before, we're going to be working into the back V's of the row previously. So we're going to yarn over and insert into the back loop of the V here. So into that back loop just there. And do your treble. I'll show you that once more. Yarn over and into the back loop. And again, you're just going to work that all the way along your row, working into the backs of the V's here. So if you meet me again, just pause the video and I will meet you back at the end of this row. Okay, so I'm just reaching the end of this row again now, and I'm just making sure that I'm catching the top loops of this end chain three here from the last row, and I'm just going to work my final treble of this row. I'm going to chain three again, and now I'm going to turn my work and work back along once more into the sides of the stitches here. And I'm going to do my next buttonhole as well. So just the exact same process as before. I'm going to yarn over, insert into the bottom side of this row, and pull up and do my treble. It's always a little bit tricky, this first one. Just like this. And now I'm going to chain one for my button. And then I'm going to miss this stitch here, and I'm going to work straight into this stitch over here. So again, we're not working into the tops, we're working into the sides of the stitches just here. So insert into there and do your treble. And now continue working back along just as we did before, working into the bottom side of the stitches here. And I'll meet you back at the end of the row once more. Okay, I've just worked my final stitch into the top of my chain three here, and I'm going to chain three and move on to my final row. Now I say final row, but obviously it doesn't have to be your final row. You can repeat this pattern as many times as you like until you reach your desired width. I'm going to do my final row into the backs of my V's. However, if you were to continue doing more rows, you would obviously do this row into the back of your V, and then the next row into the side of your V here at the bottom, and add in your button space, and then you would do your next row again into the top of your V, and again your next row into the bottom of the side here, and include your button space. So I'm going to work my final row now into the back of the V's. So yarn over and insert. I'm going to do my treble, and I'm going to work all the way along again in the back of my V's. So meet me back there, and then it's just going to be a case of finishing off and sewing on your buttons. So I've just done my final treble into the top of my chain three, and that is the end of the rows that I'm going to be doing. So I'm just going to snip off my yarn. And I'm just going to yarn over and pull through. And that's it. That's the end of the crochet part of this tutorial. And you can see it does look really nice. It is a lovely, very effective stitch, especially in the super chunky yarn. And if you don't have super chunky yarn, you can always use two threads of just normal chunky yarn together. That's what I did with the blue and white scarf that I showed you at the beginning of this tutorial. So you can see we've got our three buttonholes here. So now it's just a case of sewing in our ends and popping on our buttons. So I'm just going to sew in my ends. So if you meet me back after you've sewn in your ends, and I'll do the first button with you just to show you in case you're not sure. Okay, so I've just threaded in, weaved in my ends, and now I'm going to pop the buttons on. So if you just lie your work flat, this is the back facing up. Obviously our ridges are on the other side. So if you put your ridges down, and then I'm going to fold one side across like this, and then the other end is the one with the buttonholes, and I just like to pop it across my work like this, and our buttonholes here, and just line it up roughly with the edge of the other side. And I'm just going to sew my buttons on now. So to do this, just mark out where you need your first button to go. So I'm going to do this bottom one here with you, but it'll be the same for the next two buttons as well, or however many buttons you've chosen to use. After you've sewn one on, you will just fold it back over like this and just check the placement of where your next one needs to go, and then you can attach your button onto this side of your scarf. So I'm going to do this first one here down at the bottom. So I'm literally just going to pop my finger through the middle of the hole and then see where it brings me out here. So I'm going to attach my first button just here. So to do that, I'm going to turn my work over, keeping hold of where the button needs to be, and I'm going to insert my hook just under a loop like this, and then I'm going to get, I've got my yarn threaded onto my darning needle already, and I'm just going to snip off a length approximately 30 centimetres and just snip it off. And I'm going to leave the needle end just up here for a moment, and I'm just going to pull the tail end of this yarn through like that. It just makes it a little bit easier, and then I'm simply just going to tie it on just like that. And then where I've attached it, I'm going to grab my darning needle and I'm just going to insert through the back up onto the front of my work here. Okay, so now I'm going to pop my button on. So I'm just using these 34mm coconut buttons. I just love them. So I'm simply going to insert my needle. It can be stiff obviously because I'm using such a thick yarn, and I'm going to pull all the way up and then pull my yarn right through, and I'm simply going to pop my needle back through the button into the other hole and pull through all the way underneath my work. And then what I like to do, because you don't want it sitting too flush with your work, because obviously the yarn is quite thick, so it does need a little bit of give to be able to push it through the buttonhole. So to do that, simply pop your needle back through your work, but don't go through the hole on your button, just bring your needle up underneath your button like this and pull your yarn through. And then simply just wrap your yarn around your button. I'm just going to do it twice. And then it just gives it a little bit of a bumper so that it doesn't sit too flush on the work. And then I'm going to pop my yarn back underneath my button and through onto the back side of the work again. And I'm just going to pull it through. And that's it, that's my button attached. I couldn't put the yarn through again even if I wanted to, because the yarn is so thick. It will only go through these buttons one time because the holes are quite small. So now all you simply need to do is just secure it a little more firmly on the back. So I'm going to insert my needle once more, just into any loop really that's nearby. And I'm just going to pull it through, but before I pull it all of the way through, I'm just going to keep hold of a loop and pop my needle back through that loop, and then pull nice and tight to secure, and then I'm just going to weave in this end. So you don't need to be really accurate with it, but just weave it in along your work and pull it all through. And I'm going to snip this end off here now. And then it's just a case of weaving in the tail from the very beginning. So meet me back once you've done that and we'll talk about the next button. So that's it, that's your first button on here. And just pop your other side of your scarf back over and just pop it through. Make sure it fits through nice and fine and that it's got enough of a gap to keep it through. And then you're simply going to repeat that for your other buttons here. So you'll have one more here and another one here, or however many you chose to do. So if you go ahead and sew the rest of your buttons on, and I will meet you back in a few moments. Okay, so I've sewn on my three buttons now. So I'm just going to fasten it up. And there we have it, that is your completed super chunky loose knit scarf. I really hope that you've enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope that you have actually been able to complete the project. And if you did, just give me a thumbs up, and if you'd like to subscribe, then I will be doing obviously lots more tutorials in the future. So thank you for watching.